Leap to Leaders, it is day 6. It's Scentsy Superstar Director Scott Wickfree. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel. If you are an outsider and looking to join Scentsy and checking out all the training online, you should find details of the Wickfree somewhere up here around about now. Boom! But anyway, for those attending the Leap to Lead course, welcome to day 6. Congratulations, almost a week of consistency. And that is key to this business, is consistency. If you haven't been through all the videos, now is the time to go back and go through all the videos. Keep up. We're giving 10 minutes of information. It's short, it's sweet, and we're also giving a small challenge, which is pretty easy to do. And as I say on every video, it's easy to do, but easy not to do. So you've got to get your own self-discipline in order to make sure you do them. Self-discipline is a problem a lot of people have when they're self-employed. Okay, an independent business owner in Scentsy, you have to have a bit of self-discipline. Okay, and that is why people don't succeed in business, because they don't have that self-discipline. They like to be told what to do, what time they start work, what time their dinner break is, and what time they're finished. But really, if you have a 1 hour to 2 hours of self-discipline every single day, you can easily replace that income of a full-time job and be smart and earn the money of a full-time job working a lot less hours. Okay, so you gotta have self-discipline, you gotta be smart, and you gotta do income-generating activities. That is today's nugget. So yesterday, we talked about the follow-up. The day before, we talked about putting yourself, getting your dream team together, contacting them about starting their own Scentsy business, and also posting on your social media and following up to all your customers since August the 1st, joiners, potential party hosts, you name it. Okay, I hope you've done that. Easy to do, but very easy not to do. So let's make sure we get the easy jobs done and dusted. Now today, I'm gonna talk about a subject which, from 9 years in Scentsy, a lot of people worry about this subject. They worry about recruiting their customers, because then they get scared that they are not going to get any customers. I will tell you right now, okay, your best consultants are your customers. First of all, I'm going to teach you the simple rule of business to be successful in Scentsy, okay? You've got to get some customers. You offer the customers the opportunity. Not all the customers say yes. They still remain your customers. But though what you do, those who do become team members, okay? And then you've got to go out there and rebuild that customer base, refill that customer base with the customers you lost as your team starts to grow, because you're recruiting your customers, and it goes in a circle like that, and you teach others and help others to do the same. Boom! No 1,000-page manual needed to how to run a Scentsy business and how to be successful. Us today, superstar directors, okay, top of the company, in the top 20 in the company, that's all we do. Okay, the difference between us and other people who aren't successful is we do it consistently. That simple. Build up your customer base, recruit your customers, teach the team members to do the same, replenish your customers with brand new customers, and do the process again. That easy, that simple. Okay, what you got to realize is, okay, sales are the income for today. So I sell a warmer, okay? You give me the cash, you take the warmer, that goes in my back pocket, or whatever you want to do with it, you know, today. Yep, parties are the income for tomorrow. It is what, September the 7th, September the 8th, September the 6th, 7th, 8th, I don't know, okay? Party's the income for tomorrow. I've got a party on September the 15th. I am gonna get paid for my hard work on that party on October the 15th. So that is income for tomorrow. Me doing work in September, I'm gonna get paid for in October. But if you get team members who put in orders every single month or go on to do great things within their Scentsy business, okay, that is an income for a lifetime. Yep, so I want you to have in that in your head. When people don't want to recruit their customers, they are thinking very, very, very short term, okay? Because you might recruit your next door neighbor. Your next door neighbor has far more, you know, it's like me and our next door neighbor, okay? Our next door neighbor, okay, they would have contacts all over different places than us. We would have contacts in different places than them. It doesn't matter, because we, you know, on the geographic side of things, we are like this. It doesn't mean we're gonna sit in the same circles, okay? So what we used to live in a town in Ireland of 200 people and had 5 consultants, and we never used to bump into each other. So I want you to get out of that head that recruiting your best customers is going to create saturation in your town. It is not. Okay, it is going to make business a lot easier and a lot better. And if you don't recruit your best customers, someone else probably will. Okay, so never have that short-term outlet. Remember, get a customer base, recruit your best customers, teach your team members to do the same, replenish the customers, repeat, 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 repeat. Scentsy success. Okay, so I can gather you are guessing where we are headed with this one. What is today's challenge? I want you to go back to every single customer you've ever had, and I want you to offer them the opportunity, okay, of Scentsy. I'm just going to give you a bit of sales tips here. Many people always tell me that they could sell Scentsy all day, but they don't know how to recruit. What do you sell Scentsy on? You sell Scentsy on the benefits. The benefits of being safe, you know, child safe, pet safe, no sort, no toxins, lifetime warranty. Big, big, big sales pitch there, lifetime warranty, guys. So what do you sell the opportunity on? You sell the opportunity on the benefits of the opportunity. You can work from home, it's flexible, get an extra few hundred euros around your children, work it when you want, get discounted Scentsy, you know, something for you to do, great community. Sell the benefits. Learn about the benefits of your Scentsy business, okay? Today's bonus video is gonna be an opportunity video we have done. I want you to watch that and get some ideas about what we share about this business, what we share the benefits about this business, and go to your customers and share them. Now, I'm not saying write to your customers in a spammy type of way. Hi, Alexandra, how's the warmer? Do you wanna join my team? It's not gonna work. You know, we gotta build relationships in this business. There is no shortcut, but you gotta build genuine relationships. So, hi, Alexandra, how are you doing today? How is your family? You know, I know Alexandra's been walking in the forest. How was your walk in the forest? It looked spectacular the other day on social media. How is your new warmer going? Alexandra replies, oh, I'm really loving it, blah, 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 blah. I was wondering, you know, you would be absolutely fantastic at this business. Have you ever thought about starting your own Scentsy business? Seed planted. Yep. Alexandra might not say yes now. She might not say yes when I follow up in 24 hours. She might not say yes when I follow up again in a month. But in a year's time, she might go, you know something, I think now's the right time. I remember when he offered me that opportunity, okay? So don't be shy and don't be spammy when messaging your customers. That is today's message. I want you to message every single customer, create a conversation, and then plant the seed about becoming a consultant. Bit out of your comfort zone today, guys, but that is where ultimately where the magic happens. Yep, as I say, and I will do many videos on this, okay? If you're married, if you have a boyfriend, if you've ever been married, you've ever had a boyfriend, I guaranteed for that relationship to start, one of you had to ask. If you want something in life, you have to ask. If I want another coffee and the server doesn't offer it me, I ask. Yep, it's the same in business. If you want to progress, you have to ask. Yep, not rocket science, really easy to do. Once again, really easy not to do. It is to ask people. So anyway, that is today's video. I think you got the and challenge. I think you got the gist of it. Up here will be one of our opportunity meetings, today's bonus video. Check it out, get some ideas, do your homework. Tomorrow we're having a rest day. So you can, a catch-up day. Wrong word there, Scott. A catch-up day so you can catch up on all the tasks. And I will be with you in 48 hours when everything's all caught up with and we are moving on to basket parties. How these are great sellers, how to recruit your best basket party host, what you get in your basket party, what to put in your basket party, and how to make sure you generate the best sales. So, enjoy, guys. Let's make things happen. Looking forward to seeing many of those team members come in. Remember, video one, 1,250 PRV minimum, and we're aiming for 3 recruits. If you don't do it, you will still be alive, guys, but I want you to aim for it. Make that your why, and the how will sort itself out. See you tomorrow or in 48 hours. Boom.